Now I am taking business taxation of second year BCom. We already calculated the problems relating to the leave encashment. Leave encashment. The problem is like this. Kiran retired from service on February 29, 2020. After serving for 24 years. And add to his credit 10 months earned leave. So he has 10 months earned leave. Earned leave. That is here. His salary for the month of February 2019 was. So his salary is given for the month of February. Year 2019 given. It is 24,900. So his salary for the month of February in the year 2019 is 24,900. And DA at 25% of basic. So DA given 25% of basic. Next, he was entitled to get a annual increment of ₹500. So increment is, annual increment is 500. Which falls due on 1st September of every year. It is September of every year. Then he received ₹3,50,000 on leave encashment. So the leave encashment he is receiving 3,50,000 he is receiving the leave encashment. Find out his taxable portion of leave encashment. So we have to calculate his 10 taxable leave encashment. So before calculating his encashment of leave, taxable encashment of leave, we have to first calculate his 10 months salary. We have to calculate 10 months salary. So he is retired on February 29. So remember, now we are calculating the leave encashment and not the gratuity. If we are calculating the gratuity, then we have to write the previous month. Gratuity laguvaga now February ninde January inda baribeku. But remember always, if we are calculating 10 months salary, if he it is calculated for leave encashment, then take this month only. Leave encashment yakuvaga ide month annu tagolbeku yavudannu February. Adhe 10 months calculation maduvaga if he is not covered under the gratuity act anta kottaga neevu 10 months salary calculation maduvaga matra naavu ili February indre enarthi jan. But in case of leave encashment, take the same month, that is February 29 itself. Then we have to calculate with increment and without increment. So first we can see the with increment. Another one is without increment. Without increment. So with increment means, see here, he is retired in the month of February 2020. The salary is given for February 2019 and increment is due in September. So February 2019, 24,900. Then that year, that is 2019, in the month of September, he is getting the increment. So 2019 February 24,900. That nantara prati September ante helvaga February alli March April me hage hogta September ge baruvaga avarige eshtu increment siktare 500. So with increment how much you will get? 24,900 opening plus 500 increment. That you will get 25,400. Then how many months? So September, October, November, December, January, February. We have to take February month also here. Because once again we are calculating leave and cash. We are calculating leave encashment. That is why take this February. So from September to February, it will be 6 months. 6 months. So we get 1,52,400. Then without increment means 24,900 itself. Without increment means same amount, 24,900. So now we are calculating for 10 months salary. So 10 minus 6. So we here we have to take 4. So without increment is 4 months because here it is 10 month. So 10 month salary. We are calculating 10 months average salary. That is why 6 month is with increment. Remaining 4 is without increment. So we are getting 99,600 here. 99,600. Add it, we get 2,52,000. 2,52,000. See here, we should not add DA. DA is not taken into consideration here because in the problem it is not given. DA is enters into retirement benefit. In case of leave encashment. If the DA is a DA or DP enters into the retirement benefit, then only we have to take it into consideration while calculating 10 months salary. So DA will takodilla, like a retirement benefit ki bandide anta kodilla. So leave encashment alli DA and DP retirement benefit ki bandre matra ee salary ge add madu. So here there is no need of adding DA. So this is the salary, 10 months salary. So now we can easily calculate the taxable encashment of leave. So now next we have to calculate the computation of taxable leave encashment. Taxable leave encashment. And at first we have to write amount received on leave encashment. Amount received on leave encashment, it is given here. He is receiving leave encashment of rupees 3,50,000. So in the problem it is clearly given. He is receiving the leave encashment of 3,50,000. Less exempt under section 10AA. Under that we have to write list of the following. Under that number A, amount received on leave and encashment. Amount received on leave and encashment is 3,50,000. Number B is 10 months salary. It is not 10 months salary, it is just 10 months salary. We already calculated 10 months salary is 2,52,000. Then number C is salary for the approved period. Salary for the approved period, that means how much days or how much month is taking the encashment. So here it is clearly given. He is earning, taking 10 months earned leave. So he is taking 10 months earned leave. So salary for the approved period is, see here, it is for the 10 month. We already calculated 2,52,000 for the 10 month. So we have to divide by 10. Then we are getting 25,200. It is for 1 month. We are earning 10 months leave encashment. So now here we have to multiply by 10. So here we have to multiply by 10. It is same. 2,52,000. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 10 ಅನ್ನು ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಲಾಗಿದೆ ಇದೆ. ಇದು 10 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ನಮಗೆ 1 ಮಂತ್ ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ 1 ಮಂತ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, 10 ಇಂದ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ 25,200. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಈಸ್ ಎನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶಿಂಗ್ 10 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಅರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಲೀವ್. ಅವನ 10 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಇದು ಇಯರ್ ಇದು ಅವನೇ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾನೆ, ಎನ್ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಬೈ 10. ಸೊ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್. Then last one is statutory limit. Statutory limit is 3 lakh. So whichever is less we have to take. So 3,50,000, 2,50,000, 2,50,000, 3,00,000. So it is least of the following is 2,52,000. If we deduct 2,52,000, we are getting the taxable encashment of earned leave. Taxable encashment earned leave is 98,000. That means if he is receiving 3,50,000 gratuity, then he should pay the tax 98,000. So out of 3,50,000, 98,000 is the taxable encashment of earned leave. So over. Thank you.